Gary Washburn.
How in your relationship with Jayson, when he came back from Tokyo and he went to Vegas and he put the gold medal around you and there's a picture, and it just seems like you guys are close. How has that relationship evolved over the last several months, especially the difficulty of last season? And can you guys be the two heads of the snake and play together and take this team to the next level? Is there any concern about that?
What's the first question? Give me all
the relationship with Jayson and how it's grown last season.
It's definitely grown a lot. I think it's centered around respect. I think there's a respect there. Jayson respects my work ethic. I respect his. We both put a lot into this game, regardless of what I do off the court, or what people think that I do off the court. You know, I put my everything, my heart and soul into this game. So I think our relationship is built around respect. You know, I respect Jayson. I think he's one of the best players in this game, regardless of 25, under or over. And I think he can be one of the best players to when it's all said and done. I think the same about myself. So I think respect is what the relationship is centered around. And then in terms of what was the second question?
About you guys being able to play together, be those two heads of the snake.
Yeah, I think the media likes to dichotomize things and puts one thing against the other. Like, it has to be, you know, a Batman and a Robin, or, you know, one guy and the other guy can't be whatever. We're just two guys that can hoop. And the reality is two guys that can hoop can cause this. But, you know, the media wants to, you know, kind of sometimes write the story that pulls us apart. But we talk a lot. We don't let it bother us. You know, we hear a lot of the things, the comparisons, et cetera. But at the end of the day, I want the best for him. He want the best for me, regardless of, you know, what everybody's saying, that we can't coexist and we don't play well together or whatever. I enjoy playing with Jayson. I really do. It's a guy I trust out there to make plays. You know, I know he can carry, and I know he trusts me out there as well. And sometimes that's not always easy to find. We kind of started our careers together. We won a lot of games here in Boston together at an early age, which is rare. It's sometimes fascinating to me to see, you know, such an urgency to kind of to pitch us against each other at times. But, you know, I could care less about the what you read and see. So it doesn't really bother me none. I just try to come out and be the best version of myself. I want the best for my teammates, and I want the best for myself as well. So we just take that one day at a time.
John Corrales.
Hey, Jaylen. I know it's early, but have you noticed anything different about Marcus now that he's kind of installed as the primary point guard and expects to be the primary point guard for the season? Do you feel that there's any added comfort level from him or anything different on the court?
Not as of yet. Same old Marcus we all know and love. Still cursing people out, you know, complaining to the refs, you know, letting his voice be heard. So I'll keep you updated as things kind of go on. But same old Marcus, for sure.
Mark Murphy.
Hey, Jaylen. How would you characterize the conversation between players and the Players Association right now about getting vaccinated or not getting vaccinated?
There's been a lot of conversation around it. And, you know, amongst NBA players, I think the NBA and the union has done a great job. I think it's WNBA is 99% vaccinated, and I think the NBA is over 90%. So I think the NBA and the union has done a really good job. In certain states and certain entities that are not at that percentage level. So sometimes it's interesting to see what the concern is and with the NBA. The NBA is doing a really good job, and so is the union. But everybody has, you know, their own thoughts about it. You know, personally, I have my closest family members who are vaccinated. I have family members who are vaccinated who are, you know, concerned with getting a booster shot and or multiple booster shots. And then I have some people in my family who aren't vaccinated at all. So just depending on, you know, your situation, your family, how you feel, I think that lets the agenda kind of be set for each and every individual. But I think the NBA and the Players Association are definitely are the front runners in terms of society about getting vaccinated.
Abby?
Hi, Jaylen. Just overall impressions, first 2 days in camp, what stood out to you?
Pace. I think that we want to play fast. And we got a lot of guys that can do that. Today was fun because I've been saying for years, I want to play fast. And I think we got the personnel to do so. We got bigs who can run, who can play make. We got guards who love to get up and down the court. And to me, that's music to my ears. So today, pace was, I think, an emphasis.
Amanda Flugrad.
Hey, Jaylen, Ime had said you and JT are obviously the pillars of this Celtics team, but he also said he wants to help elevate you guys as playmakers. I know it's only day two, but how have you seen that so far with him?
We've seen it a lot. He trusts us with the ball in my hand. He trusts me with the ball in my hands a lot more, you know, to make plays for others. So it's a great responsibility. You have to, with great responsibility, you know, you have to, you know, the Spider-Man shit that everybody says, you know what I mean? So just trying to take care of the ball, make plays for others, make plays for myself, read the game, read the defense, you know, just continue to develop that basketball IQ, and it should be fun.
Brian Robb?
Hey, Jaylen. I know it's only been a couple of days. How's the experience been like just working under EMA and the new, a lot of the new staff you have here, and how are you feeling physically after a couple of days of camp with your wrist?
I feel good. I feel really good. My body feels well. Like I said, I feel athletic. I feel light. I feel fast. I'm in shape. My wrist, as for my wrist, like, got to continue to keep pushing. Like, some days it's like a little sore right now. Nothing to really worry about too much, but just trying to keep it and kind of break through that scar tissue that's still there. You know, wrist is like one of the harder things to heal. It's great that it's my offhand, but it still has a tremendous effect on my game, my shooting, my ball handling, and, you know, my defense, putting my hand in there. So just using our staff to continue to get better and whatnot.
Last two questions. Jared Weiss is first.
Dylan, you talked about on media day how you want to have a very like kind of two-way street relationship with Ime and have that kind of quote-unquote hard coaching kind of come out of that. So what has that experience been like so far? And have you kind of taken that and tried to be an extension of him out there on the court?
It's been good. I think he's done a great job. I think he's, you know, establishing himself as a leader, and we are going to follow his lead. We all are bought in. We all are trying to learn. You know, everybody on the staff is new for a lot of the guys that's been here. But, you know, we're trying to do our best to gel together. And because it's building chemistry is, I think, the most important thing. But, you know, I think we have a little bit of a natural cohesion, you know, but we definitely got to work through some kinks. And I'm looking forward to doing that. I'm looking forward to the ups and downs of this season because that's what life is about. I'm looking forward to the journey.
Final question from Sherrod Blakely.
Jaylen, we know Mark isn't just what he's going to bring, the intensity defensively, but when you add a guy like Josh and you add a guy like Dennis, speak to what this team's potential from a defensive standpoint looks like in that backcourt when you got a couple more dogs in the yard with those two in the mix now.
Yeah, between Dennis, Josh, Mark, Rob, you know, I think we got a chance to be really good defensively. We just got to, you know, continue to build that defensive communication and awareness with each other. And I think we can really do some damage, especially if we're playing at that pace that we want to play at. I'm looking forward to that side of the ball this year. So I'm ready to get after.
We'll wrap it up right there. Thank you, Jaylen.
Thank you, guys.